Hi guys, I know all of you all are working from home and figuring out how to ace your productivity because everybody is working remotely. Now, we've been working remotely for a while. We have teams based in Delhi, Calcutta, Bangalore, and even remotely within Bombay. We have contributors all across the country, but this is something that we've kind of learned and mastered, and we work very, very efficiently even when we're working remotely. So today I'm going to share with you a couple of apps that I think everybody must consider, and these are must downloads because they really increase your productivity and you'll really ace working remotely. Okay, so the first app, and I'm going to tell you what we use these for. So the first one app is if you guys want to do video conferencing or look at, you know, having face-to-face interaction at some point, two apps that I would totally recommend is, one is Zoom. Now Zoom Cloud Meetings is a fabulous app if you guys are like 10 people wanting to get into a meeting and discussing stuff. We do our weekly meetings on Zoom. The other one you can use is Google Hangouts as well. It works brilliantly. If you're about 4 or 5 people, you could even use WhatsApp video because you can keep adding about 4 or 5 people. We do that sometimes as well, depending on where we are, and I use that for my family as well, so it works brilliantly. So that's on video meetings. The other one that I absolutely love, which is on on putting systems, protocols and productivity hacks, is Asana. Now this one is where you can add up to 15 members in a team in the free version, and again this works really well because you can put all of, you know, so you can create, you know, different projects. Example, we just launched our meal plan book, so we put meal plan book as a project, and then we put different subsections in it, like how we're going to do the promotion, how we're going to do the pre-launch, how we're going to get it in stores, so how's distribution going to be, how's the communication on it going to be, and then you can assign people tasks and deadlines, and then you can go back and track it. You can upload attachments, pictures, discussion notes. You know, you can document all of it, plus it notifies the person when something has been assigned to him or her. So I would totally recommend using Asana. The other one that we use extensively and is an absolute must use is Google Drive. Now we use Google Drive for, you know, sharing videos. Like I'm shooting this video remotely, but it's going to reach my editor. And if you need to buy space on Google Drive, just go ahead and do it. But Google Drive really, really works. And we use a lot of Google Sheets for, you know, putting on our SOPs, like, okay, if this is what we need to create, what will be the SOP for this? Now, this works very well if you have a lot of changing hands as well. You know, what often happens is that when I started, you know, I had a certain framework that I would follow for every particular task. And then you want to ensure that there's continuity. Now, how do you ensure going about that? Is that you document it. So once there is an SOP that exists for it, it becomes very easy for the next person coming in to follow, okay, if I need to accomplish this task, I need to do step 1, 2, 3 until 10, right? So it works brilliantly. So I would totally recommend Google Sheets, Google Drive. Also, if people are working across different operating systems, like I work on a Mac and somebody else could work on a Windows. So it works really, really well because you don't have to keep reformatting your files as well. So try using Google Sheets and Google Docs as much as you can. The next one app that I would love to share, and it's one of my favorites, is Evernote. Now, Evernote is an app that we use for a lot of stuff where we need to make sure that if you need to find something, it's there. So example, your passport, right? I use it a lot for personal and professional. But for personal, I use for passport or important documents and stuff. And for professional, I would use for our PAN cards, our certificate of incorporation, memorandums, different agreements that you want to constantly keep relooking or need to be shared with a team. If it's something you want to share with only one member of the team, you can do that. If you want to share it with all the members of the teams, then you can do that as well. So I think that really, really works for us. And of course, I'm going to refer to my notes for a few of the others. Okay, the other one that we use extensively is also Slack. Now, we used to use that, but I actually found it very useful once I switched to Asana and another app that I'm going to tell you about. But Slack also offers a lot of communication and works well if you guys haven't used that. Next up is another one that I use, which is called Trello. Now Trello I use a lot for trainings that I attend because I want to understand, example, you know, if it's January and these were the trainings or these were the meetings that I attended, what were the key takeaways, what were the project points discussed. And I make it actually month-wise as well because I attend a lot of online courses, a lot of trainings online. So it works very well for that. You can again add people onto it. If you're a business and you're pursuing clients, you want to also say, okay, these are my hot clients, these are my warm clients, these are my ongoing clients, these are cold clients, right? And if people want to add in clients or new leads that have come, you can also do that on Trello. Okay, last but not the least, guys, one thing when you're working remotely, and especially in times like today, is make sure that, you know, you're not upset with your kids. You're as transparent with your, you know, if you're getting on a voice call or you're getting on a video call with a team member or with a client, if your kids just come in and, you know, or there's noise in the background or you have a child crying, it's okay. Everybody understands that you're working remotely and, you know, it's okay if your kids come in because we're all in it together, right? Because we have, you know, one of my team members has just had a baby 6 months ago and we're sometimes doing a Zoom call and a baby suddenly starts crying. But that's okay because she's way more efficient. Even if the baby's crying, she'll just say, hey, can I call you back? And then she joins in the call 5 minutes later or maybe 30 minutes later if you guys can reschedule it. Then that is okay as well. You know, I also like to get my kids to, you know, I introduce them to my clients sometimes or to my team members, most definitely, because everybody knows everybody. Everybody knows everybody's bachas as well. So I think it's absolutely okay because that kind of makes it all one big cohesive family. So please do not be annoyed or do not lose your patience or energy in getting angry at all of these things because these are just the smaller aspects and I don't think anybody is gonna have a problem with it. So guys, I hope you enjoy watching this video, and if you use any apps which have really, really worked for you, then please do share them in the comments below.